of the Lord. Amen. They shall call you the servants of God. And in case you're wondering, and this passage, servants mean ministers of God. Do you realize that God says, I'm going to call you a minister? You're like me with all my mess, me with all the problems, me with all that turmoil, me the black sheep of the family. You mean me the one nobody want to talk to, me the one that keep closing the door, me? The Lord God said, yes. I told you. He said, look at the word. I hope that God bless you. But you shall be named the priest of the Lord, and they shall call you ministers of God.
Yes.
And you shall eat what? Riches of the Gentiles. That means the wealth of the wicked is stored up for the righteous.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Somebody better get that one in the name of Jesus. The wealth of the wicked is stored up for the righteous.
Hallelujah.
That means the delicacy that the wicked are eating.
Yes, Lord.
Those new cars that they didn't pay for. They didn't pay for them cars. That's the people word that we pay for that. Come on,
that's right. Yeah.
And but we're watching them little shows and we supporting them. That's we pay for them.
Amen.
We didn't pay that up there. How you get no job and you're on a TV show and you don't work at all?
Amen. No sweat. Amen.
Who you think paying for that? Those of us that click on to see what they're doing.
Mm-hmm. Yes. No, that's right.
They're not working, you working, and you paying him for them not working.
Amen. Preach it,
Pastor.
Amen.
I hope that delivers some of y'all from clicking on them little shows.
Amen.
I hope so, because they getting the check while you sitting up there paying them.
Jesus.
Every time you log on to see what they doing, they get a check. They get a check.
Yeah.
They get more than the body of Christ by you sitting there going, what they doing?
Amen.
Jesus. They feeding the dog. Ooh, you just paid them $150 to feed the dog.
Jesus.
Because you watched them feed Boo Boo.
Yes, Lord.
Oh my God.
Yes. And it's the truth.
Amen.
And it's the truth. Amen. I'm finding out that these individuals have no employment, but yet you work 20, you work, you get up, you go to work,
that's
you
right.
pay your tithe, you give an
my
offer,
God.
You yes. give God glory, the sweat of your brow, you're giving God glory, and surely you're working hard, and they just come and they just sit down and do nothing.
Uh-huh.
Brush their teeth.
Yes.
I brush my teeth at 7 a.m.
And this.
Who cares?
Amen.
My God. Jesus. But I'm here to tell you, there are people making millions.
Yes.
Yes.
Not still working. Lord, have mercy. That's pray right. for this generation.
Yes, yes. Lord.
Ooh, because at least yes, this Lord. Generation in here, we know how to work.
Amen. Amen.
And they think they just put the TV on and grin.
Uh-huh.
And a paycheck gonna come because that's what
they do.
That's what they're seeing.
Yeah.
But the Bible says, and I went there to tell you that. But see all that riches that you see, mm-hmm. that you see on the all them cars and the bling bling and the cling cling, all of that. The Lord God says, look, I stored it up for the righteous. Yes.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. Ooh,
I stored it up
Lord.
For the righteous.
My God.
Thank you, Lord. God.
Amen.
He said, the Bible Lord. Tells you right now, and you need to receive that. That's the word. You got to receive the wealth of the wicked
Lord.
Is stored up for the righteous.
Amen. Amen.
So that means some stocks and bonds.
Yes. Ooh, yes.
Come on
yes.
up in here.
Yes,
Lord
yes,
God. Yes. You see, some of y'all don't think of bonds and investments.
Right.
Later, when they go,
that's
the right. stock market go, look, that's going to start deposit in my account.
Yes, Lord.
My account. For the kingdom of God. Come
Amen.
On. The Bible says, you shall eat the riches
yes, Lord.
Of the Gentiles.
Amen.
And he said, and in their glory, you shall boast.
Yes, Lord.
Instead of your shame.
Yes,
whenever you mess,
Lord.
Instead of being shamed, the Bible says, I'm about to give you what? Double honor. Double honor. Whenever you're feeling bad and felt bad, that you know what, maybe you messed up in your finances, maybe you messed up in your marriage,
Amen.
Maybe you messed up with your children,
yes,
maybe
Lord,
you messed
Lord.
Up with your spouse,
Amen.
Maybe you messed up on the job,
yes,
maybe
yes.
you messed up talking to mama, maybe you messed up acting around with daddy, but the Lord God said, he said, instead of your shame,
yes.
because see, you were walking around saying, oh, Lord, oh, God, I know, I said, oh, Lord, I feel bad about that, Lord. And I feel that you don't even want to pick up your head. Like, no, no.
Come on.
No, I'm not worthy. No, I don't want to do it.
Mm-mm.
The Lord God says, uh-uh. My brothers and my sisters, the Lord God said, I'm about to give you double
Amen.
Honor.
Amen.
For those
Amen.
Of you that
Thank
have walked
Lord.
Around being
Amen.
Ashamed.
Thank you, Lord.
You were in a mess. You felt
Thank
ashamed.
You, Lord.
And you're like, you know what, Lord? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cause that.
Amen.
I'm feeling bad about it already. And the Lord God says, I come to remove that garment.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm going to give you a garment.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of
Thank
Jesus.
You, Father.
And I don't know about you, but when my daddy says he's about
Thank
to give
you,
me double honor,
double
not honor one time double, twice. Twice the honor. That means you're going to be recognized and appreciated. Somebody better get that. Recognized and appreciated. It's one thing to be recognized. Recognition, like you see, I recognize that this is here. Mm-hmm. I recognize it.
Yeah.
But appreciation, well, I want to take special
Amen.
Care.
Yeah.
You see, that's one thing to be recognized, right. But to be recognized and appreciated,
Amen.
That means I see you and
yes,
I'm going to take care of you.
Amen. Yes. Yes, Lord.
I don't know why you would. That's
Hallelujah.
A double right there.
My God.
That's a double honor
yes.
right there. That's a double honor.
God
said, I will give you beauty for your ashes.
Yes,
that
Lord.
Means that all the stuff that you have been going through and
Jesus.
All the downtroddenness and where you were feeling, the Lord God said, it was your mess, but I'm about to give you beauty for that.
Amen.
That you're going to be able to pick up your
Amen.
Head in the morning. The Lord God says, dry your tears, man of God. Dry your tears, woman of God. The Lord God said, I am forgiving you beauty for those ashes.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I thank
Hallelujah.
You, Lord God, that God is saying double for all that you have gone through. Double honor instead of your shame. So you know what? The lower you have been, the higher you going to go.
Amen.
Yeah.
Oh,
yes.
Thank you, Lord God.
I'm not just talking about myself. It'll do
yes.
that. I'm saying it because we got to lay close to.
Amen.
You know, we're not going way out there. We're not talking about no enemy.
Yes.
We're talking about in the house.
That's right.
In the house.
Yes.
Oh, do you hear me? You can just do this here. Somebody talk to you. Yes, Lord. Mm-hmm. But the Lord God said, I'm going to allow you to pick your head up.
Thank you, Lord.
Because of all those things you have been going through. The Lord God says, I'm going to give you double honor.
Thank
in the name
Lord.
Of Jesus. Double honor. When they walked around and said, you're foolish for staying.
Yes. Jesus.
I'm preaching in somebody.
Amen. Amen.
When they told you that you were foolish to deal with
Jesus.
That deal. And you said, my God shall supply
yes.
all my
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
Christ Jesus. And you said, I'm not about to leave my blessing when it's
Amen.
Not there.
Yes.
And people call you a fool.
Yes.
Yes.
Have you ever been called a fool for
yes.
Christ before?
Yes.
You ever been called, a fool? Fool.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah, and you said, you praising God like he gonna give you something.
Yes. Jesus.
You thanking God like he really gonna do.
Yes.
You know, and it's a shame to say how some people don't believe in prayer so bad.
Yes.
I'm gonna share this with you. I won't disclose any name. It's a gentleman I was speaking with, and I said, you know, I gave him I said, you know what, I'm gonna pray for you. I'm gonna pray. He said, you know what, I'd rather you not.
Jesus.
He said, I'd rather you not. I'd rather you do this for me. I said, look at that. I said, you realize prayer is powerful?
Jesus.
He would rather me give a finance or do an act rather than pray. Do you realize if me praying, God can open up the window
and
hello, you don't have enough room. And to be told, that's a cold thing. To be told, I'd rather you not.
Jesus.
This day and age, we should be, you're talking about a whoa. Right there. Like, for someone to tell, I said, Lord God, I hear people say pray for me, but to be told, don't pray.
Jesus.
You know what? That's just let me know. I told you we're in the last days.
Yes.
We're in the last
yes.
days. Because people just want, gimme, gimme.
Yeah.
He would rather me give. And I'm thinking to myself, he does not know
does
God
not.
At all.
Yeah.
He does not know. He cannot know. And say, bless God.
Jesus.
Oh my God.
All right now, I'm here.
All right.
Yeah. I tell you, some people, they got the language, but they don't have the spirit.
Yeah.
Oh, come on. They got all of the language, but they don't have the spirit of the Lord.
That's right.
They know all. They know when to jump, when to shout, and they're missing the spirit of the Lord because the anointing destroys the yoke.
Amen.
If there's no anointing, there's no yoke being destroyed. That means you have all the words. Bless God. Praise
Amen.
God. He said all the bless them. But when I said I'm going to pray for you, I'd rather you not.
Jesus.
That just pulled the mask. I said, that young man does not know the Lord at all.
Yeah.
He know of him, but he
Lord,
don't know
Lord,
him.
Lord,
yes.
Lord have mercy.
He heard the name,
yes.
but he don't know the name.
Mm.
Because if you know the name, you know demons got the fear.
Amen.
At the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Things are bound.
Amen.
Every time that I walk, I say in the name of Jesus.
Yes,
let the devil in the name
yes,
of Jesus.
Lord.
You know what? You may not hear my mouth moving, but
yes,
I'm casting
Lord.
Some devils out. In
yes,
the name
Lord.
Of Jesus, just to keep it up.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. But he does not know that. He does not know that because for you to say don't pray for me.
Jesus.
It was almost like, why don't you just curse me? That's what I felt. I'm just going to tell you. When you don't want prayer,
amen.
And believe it or not, I'm about to call the people of God. There are some people, there are so much that they're in such a mess that they don't even want prayer.
Jesus.
That's when you know when they've hit rock bottom.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
When they hit rock bottom, when they said, don't pray for me.
Lord.
Matter of fact, keep your prayers.
Oh, my God. Lord.
Then you know what? That's when we should pray all the more.
Yes.
Because they are on,
right.
They on death's door.
Right.
Yes.
I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you something. Somewhere. They are knocking at death's door. You're asking, you're saying, please don't pray for me. The enemy has you deceived.
Right.
And you're on your way to hell.
Yes.
Jesus.
And you need as much prayer. You know, we get a whole wall of warriors to pray for you.
Amen.
Because you must understand that's how the enemy has you right there at death's door.
Yes.
But that was a mess. I'm here to tell you. I wanted to share that because it was unheard of for some individual to say not to pray for me.
Lord,
Just give me. I'm being quiet, but we know we got people like that.
Yes,
we're being quiet, but you tell my prayer, but if you can just give me, give me, I'll be all right.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to keep going.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I'm going to leave that alone.
Yeah.
But like I said, he gives you double. Instead of the shame, he's going to give you double honor. People of God, God says that your mess is going to become your miracle. And when your miracle turns, and God bless you, when it becomes your miracle, God says your message is going to be your testimony.
Yes,
that Lord God, that I am set free, that Lord God, I was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see.
Yes.
You must understand that your mess turned into your miracle, and your miracle becomes your message, because
yes,
now you can testify to that individual, because everybody's failed at least once or twice in their life. Talk to me. Help me, Holy Ghost. I told you you're going to find your purpose in here today. The Lord God said, you know, your purpose, that area that you keep messing up in, that area that you keep messing up, not your neighbor, the area that you keep messing up in, and the Lord God worked a miracle for you, the Lord God said, that's your message. That's the people that you have God. That's the people that you need to start ministering to. You're like, wait a minute. You're like, wait a minute, Lord. I have enough problems with that already.
Jesus.
And the Lord God said, but that's your message. He said, because just like I brought you out,
yes,
you need to give that person a word and say, God gonna bring you out.
Amen.
You see,
amen.
So you wonder, who am I supposed to be?
Amen.
So you know what? If you've been a single mother and raising your children all this time, and you know God has been your husband and has supplied all of your needs,
yes,
you know, and
come
you've been
on.
Crying about it, you're like, Lord God,
Lord,
I messed up, you know,
Jesus.
I didn't do what I should have done.
On.
Lord God, I made a mistake.
On,
Lord God, I'm sorry about it, Lord God.
On,
surely,
Lord.
The Lord God blessed you with the miracle that he provided for. And the Lord God said, your message, you go back and tell that other sister that you see her without a spouse.
Mm.
And she may have three or four kids struggling by herself, and tell her to get testified to and say, God is real good.
Yes, Lord.
That God will take care of you.
Yes,
God says he takes care of all of his children.
Yes.
He said, you will not lack no good thing.
Preach
those who walk uprightly.
Yes.
And of course, you know, you encourage her. You know what? You need to be married to the Lord.
Amen.
You don't need to be looking to man, because man can't supply you what God can give to you.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Because that's what's going to turn out to become your message.
Yes,
in the name
Lord.
Of Jesus. You must understand that God said your mess turns into your miracle, and
amen.
Your miracle becomes your message. Surely, men of God, if that was your error, if you had a problem in a particular area, maybe it was a bottle, or maybe it was doing something that you shouldn't have done, the Lord God said that, and God pulled you out of it,
amen.
And nobody else knew about what you were doing,
yes,
and you
Lord.
Didn't get caught while
yes.
you was doing
Come
it,
on.
The Lord God said, you need to take that
yes,
and become
Lord.
Your message, and say, you know what, young man, I see what you're doing.
Yeah.
I know the path that you're going down. I ran it myself.
Uh-huh.
I'm one player, no another player.
Yeah.
Come on,
yeah.
Come
yeah.
That I know what it looks like.
Yeah.
I know what it sounds
That's
like.
Right.
I know the
That's
talk
right.
and I know the walk.
Come on,
that's all about something. But I'm here to tell you that you can turn your life around. You can have an encounter
yes.
with God,
Lord.
And sure, and God can give you. Call you a man of God.
Yeah.
He said, "I know," and you can testify and say, "I know," because if He done it for me, He can do it for you.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, you must understand that as I close today, that God said that your master can become your miracle,
yes,
and your
Lord.
Miracle can surely become your message.
Yes,
in the name
Lord.
Of Jesus. So surely you have a purpose to do in the name of Jesus. As you come into the house, you must understand that God said you have a purpose in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
That no matter what you have done, no matter how far you've fallen, no matter what mistake you might have made, the Lord God said that your mess, I'm about to give you beauty for it.
Yes.
I'm about to clean it up. The point is that you have done, no matter where you have gone, no matter how far the outer limits that you have pushed it, the Lord God said that as I blessed you with a miracle, now get out and testify.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Whenever you start preaching a real testimony, then people really go get saved.
Yes, Lord.
You need to really tell that I was the one that's hooking the jaw.
Yes, Lord.
I was the one in the cup. I was the one cursing. I was the one lying.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
But surely because of my mess, the Lord God gave me purity for that. I'm not cussing no more.
Yes, Lord.
I'm not smoking no more. I'm not hustling. I'm not lying. I'm not stealing. He said, surely that becomes my message because I received a miracle in the name of Jesus.
Amen, amen, amen.
That the people of God need to hear the real testimony.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, glory to God. Yeah, God paid your bill. Yeah, glory to God. But that's not the real testimony, baby.
Yes, Lord.
Tell them how you come on, tell them how he made you not commit adultery when you wanted to.
Yes, Lord.
Come on. You want to sell that drug, and you were just right there.
Jesus.
And the Lord God snatched you out of there. That's
Lord.
That's what I'm talking about. You need to, that's the testimony that you need to bring forth. That said, Lord God, I know they're doing things right, but it was taking so long. So, Lord God, I cheated.
Oh, Jesus, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I made a 1 of 7.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody better hear me up in there. I made a 1 of 7.
Yes,
you know,
Lord.
So I'm all up in your business.
Wow.
You know that was a 1 and you just put a little line, made it a 7.
Jesus.
Nobody know about it but you and the Lord. But the Holy Spirit is here today to say, you know what? I gave you a miracle. He said, I allow you to get that increase. Even though you didn't deserve it.
Jesus.
I saw what you did.
Jesus.
I saw what you did. And he said, I allow you to receive that miracle.
Yes.
And you will receive that miracle. He said, but nothing but my grace.
Yes.
Hallelujah. That covered you.
Amen.
That
covered
you. What had taken place. But the Lord God says, he said, now you're going to learn. You don't have to do those things. I will supply.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord.
He said, because the opportunity is going to come up again.
Preach it, Pastor. Preach it, Pastor.
The opportunity will come up again.
Amen.
I told you the Bible said evil is always present.
Yes.
I'm telling you, a mess is right around the corner.
Yes, Lord.
Something you to step in.
Yes, Lord.
It's just exactly the way a message. Some people, when you're like, that's exactly how evil is present. Wait a minute, you know, he doesn't want you to just say, wait a minute. The enemy gonna put it right in your pathway.
Amen, amen.
And it's right in your way.
Amen.
Can't go around. And you're
around.
Woo!
Preach your pastor.
Because it's going to take you longer to go around.
You got to go through it.
Quicker to go through it.
Amen.
And 9 times out of 10, like people like we are.
Yeah.
Right there. That's right. Because that's too far. I'm tired already. I don't want to go around. They're just like us.
Amen.
God would tell you, if it took you 2 miles to go this way and take you 5 seconds to get right there, which one you gonna do?
5 seconds.
I don't know anybody go, oh, I'm gonna take the 2 miles. God, give me 2 miles. First time you're like, well, Lord, I know you a cleanser, so.
Wow.
Walk right through. I'm using that as an example.
Amen.
Amen. You do that.
Yes.
Amen.
You do that.
Amen.
God, we know that you're just going to take care of and heal me. So, and that take too long.
Yes.
That take too long.
Yes.
That take too long.
Come on.
But God says, it said that same mess, God gave you a miracle. I'm here to tell you, the Lord God is having me to lay that on thick. Whatever you have done, I want you to know that God is sending this word for you today. The Lord God says, I see you. You're not getting away with anything.
Amen. Amen.
Your neighbor.
Amen.
Come on. Come on.
Amen.
God says, I see and I know everything.
Amen.
And he said, as I know this, he said, I want you to know, I'm going to give you a miracle. The miracle.
Preach it, Pastor. Amen. Amen.
Somebody, but you know what?
I'm a grab it.
You know your stuff.
I'm a grab it.
No, I'm a be open.
Amen.
You know your stuff.
Yes, Lord.
You know you.
Yeah.
You know where you. Right. And nobody go.
My guy.
That miracle right there. Thank
you, Lord.
Now I said, now take that. As you take it, let it become your message.
Message.
Go around and just say, you know what? because you didn't do what you're supposed to do. You and go around and say, bless. You know what, you shouldn't do that.
Yes, Lord.
And they're like, well, why should I take my word for it? Mm-hmm. You shouldn't lie.
Amen. Yeah. Amen. Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to use lying because yes. It seems to be, you yes. know, transversal, it goes to male, female. You know, you're like, well, why are you always talking about you shouldn't lie? Because I lied before. You know, yeah. Don't just sit up there, well, I don't know what, you just shouldn't do it. No. You come on and say, I'm telling you not to lie because I've lied. Mm-hmm. And I'm lying. Some of us are still living a lie.
Jesus. Right. Preach it, Pastor.
We're trying to outlive a lie, right? But have we come forth to the forefront?
In the name of
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
We'd have been done with the matter
years ago.
My God. But because of that, we're like, Lord, have mercy. Mm-hmm. And so you go and you warn, you tell somebody, don't lie. Tell the truth as much as possible. And, you know, and make sure you tell them because it cleanses the
Amen.
Soul.
Amen.
You can rest better.
Right.
I'm here to tell you. You don't have to keep going around that mountain because many of you know, I told you I'm closing. Thank you, Holy Spirit. God said you're giving you beauty for your ashes. But I want you to know whenever you lie once, you got to lie to cover lies.
Uh-huh.
And then the lie, I got to lie.
Yes.
I got to lie. And I'm here to tell you. So surely enough, but I'm saying that was your mess up. And I'm saying that because we all have a mess up.
Yes, Lord.
If that was your mess up, then you know what? And God gave you a miracle and nobody found out about it. You better get before the Lord and say, thank you, Lord God.
Amen, amen.
You wonder why some people praise God the way
they do. Yes, Lord. Amen. Amen.
Yeah, so sometimes when you're wondering, why don't they, you know what, maybe because God spared
Amen.
Them.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
Them.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
And they're walking for the Lord.
Hello.
Amen.
Lord.
Yes.
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 Yes. As you know, remember, you're on the magnifying glass. What?
Yes.
What?
Yes, Lord.
Hello.
And the Lord God said, he said, look, I'm going to shoot you. He said, but you better make
Amen.
That
yes,
God,
Lord.
Somebody else, tell them not to do that.
Yes,
Amen.
Lord.
Tell them to be, you can be a strong man or woman of God. You don't have
Amen.
To do that.
Amen.
You know what? Let the truth be the truth. Hallelujah. Walk uprightly.
Yes.
Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Even though it may hurt it, even though it may take some time, it's better to take the long way than the short way.
Amen.
Because the short way, it ends quick, but I'm here to tell you, the long way, it lasts longer.
Yes.
You can enjoy it longer.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. So those of you who are saving up, you're like, Lord God, continue to save. If that's what you're doing, do it. Because the Lord God said it'll be worth it. It will be worth it. No, but if you just quick, you know, you know what? Anything that takes long is worth it. Somebody need to hear that. Anything that takes long, those relationships, them 5-minute relationships, they talk good 5 minutes later, you're like, what?
Preach it, Pastor. That's the truth. Amen.
That's all it is, talk. You get with somebody a couple of years. Let's see what they're talking like. After they done seen you lose some things. Talk to me now.
Uh-huh.
After you done seen them go, they done felt you go through some heartbreak.
Uh-huh.
They done seen you what you look like when you're not on the team.
Amen.
Let's see where they are then.
Uh-huh.
Because they're laughing, oh yeah. Wait a minute, you didn't just send me on my 10-day. Wait till you send me on my -10.
Uh-huh.
Let's see if you still want to say good morning.
Then. Yes, Lord.
That's what I'm talking about.
Amen.
But so, because see, that's a mess up, but God gives us a miracle.
Amen.
And I'm saying a miracle. The miracle is that, you know what, they stayed anyway.
Yes.
Oh,
amen.
On.
Amen.
I may not have many married folks in here, but those of you who are married, you know what I'm talking about. Ouch, man. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Everything wasn't perfect, but God said, I'm still there.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He gave you a miracle. He's still holding on. A threefold cord is still
Amen.
Not broken.
Yes. Amen.
Still not broken. Jesus. Hallelujah. And God says, let that become your message. And as I close, once again, I want you to know that doesn't exclude anybody who's gone through any type of divorce. If you've gone through a divorce, that's not the end of your life. Hallelujah. If you've gone through divorce, then that may be your ministry right there. You need to minister to somebody else who's gone through a divorce or a breakup. The Lord God says it was a mess for you, but he gave you a miracle because you lived through it.
Amen.
See,
amen.
There's a lot of people, they're dead after that. You know what? They're dead spiritually.
Yes.
Amen.
They don't want to talk to nobody else.
Jesus. Preach, Pastor.
That's a death right
Amen.
After
yeah. Uh-huh.
When they say, like, after this, oh,
Amen.
Oh yeah. That's a death right there.
Amen.
And God says, no, no, no. He said, I would love. He said that we should come together. Surely there should be an opportunity, but because of what you've gone through, the Lord God said you should be able to, and let it become your message to go around and say, you know what? I know what it's like, but you know what? Don't be bitter about it because you're gonna die in it. You know what? You can live just you and Jesus.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
You can live
yes.
And be good.
Yes.
And get sweet nothings from the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's always there. Hallelujah. Tell you sweet things in the name of Jesus. I love you. Amen. You hear? I love you more. Than
yeah. Amen. Woo! Yeah.
You're like, who said that?
Uh-huh.
All blessed. Hallelujah. All blessed. I'm telling them,
amen.
I'm encouraging those who have gone through that type of breakup.
Amen.
That's not the end of your life. That's not the end of your life. The Lord God said, use it as your message.
Amen.
Use it as a platform to minister to somebody, a young person that may be going through. Say, baby, that's not it. It's not over with. You can make it through this too. You go make it. You could be a strong man and a woman, because not
yes,
just women go through it, men too.
Yes.
Come on, men too. You get up from there. Get up.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You can arise. You will love again. You will do the things of God. Yes. And God's still on the throne. Get up.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Father God, thank you, dear Lord, for this word. I thank you, Father God, that you've given us beauty for our ashes. Now, Lord God, as I seal it right now in the wonderful name of Jesus, and Lord God, that our mess, that you're going to give us a miracle. And Lord God, and with that miracle, we will have a message.
Amen.
In the wonderful name of Jesus. We said amen.
Amen.
Come on,
amen. Thank you, Lord.